what is the competition or what is the sessions of the coaching? Yeah, so English Digital Coaching, as there are two coaching sessions that we will hold to help you as the senior high school students to improve your English language mastery. So you're speaking, particularly speaking, yeah, because we're talking about the public speaking later on. And then also the videography and also photography, because we know that there are many YouTubers and many selebgram, ya, ada banyak selebgram YouTubers yang semakin lama semakin skillsnya itu bagus gitu ya. You can enjoy watching them for, I don't know, maybe 30 minutes or so, yeah. So we'll be learning about how to be like them, yeah. And then for the competition, this is a poster and vlog making competition for you guys to show your skills from the English language mastery, of course, and also from the videography and photography skills, yeah. Those are the two events. And the theme that we hold right now is a cultural identity. So you can explain about your cultural identity. Jadi kalian tinggalnya di mana, begitu. Kemudian ada budaya-budaya apa sih yang kita itu nggak tahu atau yang penonton itu nantinya nggak tahu, yang nantinya bisa kalian sampaikan melalui vlog dan juga poster. Yeah, so the cultural identity. And then here are the schedules, so timeline-nya ya. Jadi ngapain aja sih nanti? Yang pertama adalah the digital coaching. So as I said before, there are two sessions. The first session will be held tomorrow, ya, besok nih, ya, hari Jumat, tanggal 16 April. We will begin at 2:30 to 4:30. That's not gonna be too long karena ada banyak sekali hal-hal yang atau tips-tips yang jitu ya, yang akan disampaikan oleh Pak Andreas, one of our lecturers, that will be talking more about public speaking or how to use English language to make a vlog, yeah, or to make poster, yeah, something like that. And then the second session is about the videography and photography. We'll have Pak Andreas Wijaksono, who is one of the photojournalists, yeah, from CNN, yeah, Indonesia. That will be held on Saturday, April 17, 2021. That is the first event. Now we go to the second event, which is the competition. Yeah, gimana sih registration-nya atau sampai kapan sih bisa daftarnya? Ya, do not worry, because the registration has been opened from Monday, April 12th to Wednesday, April 21st. Yeah, jadi kalau dari sekarang, you still have 1 week to register yourself and your team, yeah, because you'll be working in team. And then the due of the registration, jadi paling lambat daftarnya itu sampai April 21 di Google Form, yeah. You will have to fill in the registration form and also the receipt, yeah, because I have already uploaded or sent the rules and regulations and also the registration form through Zoom chat. Yeah, you can see that here, you can see them there, but I will also explain some of the regulations, yeah. And then for you who want to join the competition, you are obliged or you must join the coaching sessions. But if you think that I still need more time to learn, or I just want to learn, I still don't have the bravery to join the competition, it's okay. You can just join the coaching for free. Yeah, you just register yourself, you get it for free, you get the knowledge and also the information for free, yeah, for the two sessions. And then for the competition, when will you submit the work or the vlog and also the poster? That will be during Saturday, April 17 to Friday, April 30th. Ya, jadi tanggal 17 sampai 30 April. Dan paling lambat itu tanggal 30 April di hari Jumat jam 11.59 malam. Ya, nanti dikumpulkannya melalui Google Form. And then the third one is about the scoring period. Jadi nanti penilaiannya oleh our judges. That will be during Saturday, May 1st to Thursday, May 6th, 2021. Ya, waktu kita libur di hari Sabtu, ya, judges-nya kita minta tolong untuk menjuri, ya. Okay, there are three judges. Two of them are our speakers, of course. And then another one is Miss Priska Pramastiwi. She is also one of our lecturers, but she is now taking her doctoral degree in New Zealand. But then we have asked her to help us as the judge, yeah. She's very creative. Okay, that is for the scoring period. Now, what about the awarding day? Nanti menangnya, announcement-nya kapan? Yeah. This is the awarding day that will be held on Saturday, May 8, 2021 from 1 to 3:30 p.m. That will be through Zoom meeting. That is for the timeline. Now, I'm going to share you about the rules and regulations. Yeah, the one that I just sent you in Zoom chat. So the first regulation is, of course, you need to be senior high school students, but you are, yeah, dari kelas 10 dan 12, ya, kalau nggak salah ya, sekarang ya, teman-teman ya. Okay, so bisa dari kelas 10 sampai kelas 12, ya. So senior high school students, then you will show your identity card or your student card later on. And then you have to register yourself in team, ya. As I said before, you will be working in team. Satu tim maksimal 5 orang. Nanti bisa dibagi tugasnya, misalnya 3 orang untuk pemerannya yang muncul di vlog sebagai talents-nya. And then the other two can be responsible in making the poster or also being the photographer, the videographer, or also the video editor, ya, for the vlog. And then each team will make one poster and one vlog. Jadi tidak terpisah ya. Satu tim membuat satu poster dan juga satu vlog. Ya, nggak bisa terpisah gitu ya. With the theme of culture identity, as I explained. And then one team can only upload or submit one vlog and one poster. Of course, the vlog and the poster must be original. Ya, nggak boleh melanggar hak cipta dan lain sebagainya. Now, what about the vlog making? Pembuatan vlognya seperti apa? Durasinya sekitar 3-5 menit, 3-5 minutes. And because we are learning about your public speaking in English, so of course, during the vlog, you have to talk in English, yeah? 90-100% in English, but then you are allowed to use bahasa Indonesia. Mungkin ada beberapa kata-kata yang, oh, ini harus nih bahasa Indonesia atau bahasa daerah, mungkin seperti itu, ya? Then you can use that for the 10% of the whole video. But please make the subtitle of the English language. Yeah, that is a must. And then for the e-poster making, this is a digital poster. So if you have your skills in graphic designs or you want to be a graphic designer, please do so. Yeah, please join. And then the size will be A4. And then you can also use many softwares. For example, at a Photoshop, InDesign, CorelDRAW, Inkscape, Sketch, and then Illustrator and many other softwares. Yeah. Sekreatif mungkin. Now, what about the administration fee? It won't be that expensive. You know, it only costs you 50,000 for 5 members. Yeah, one team equals 5 members, and then one team only pay for 50,000. So if you have 5 members, berarti satu orang hanya bayar 10.000 gitu ya. Sisihkan sedikit pocket money-nya ya. Nanti bisa dapat yang lebih besar, siapa tahu kan? Yeah. So 50,000. That will be transferred to our account, yeah, Mandiri. That will be on our dean, Pak Lulu, or Pak Nugroho is our head of the department. And then receiptnya nanti, bukti pembayarannya yang juga akan di-upload di Google Form. So as I said before, when you try to register yourself through the link, you have to upload the registration form and also the receipt of your transfer. Ya, untuk pendaftaran seperti tadi saya bilang sampai Rabu 21 April 2021 jam 11.59. And then this is the timeline, so similar to what I explained to you before, so we will skip this one and you can follow us in our Instagram and Facebook, but maybe I think you have more Instagram, ya. Yeah? Okay. Just follow our Instagram to get the upcoming information or the updated information, and the winners of the competition will be announced on the awarding day. Yeah, tadi tanggal 8 Mei itu ya. Right. Now, this is the most important thing. That is our prizes. Ya. Tadi daftarnya cuma 50.000, tapi siapa tahu nih jadi yang paling rendah aja favorite team, bisa dapat apa aja, bisa dapat cash 1 million ya dibagi tim ya. And then you also get potongan WSP, which means that if you want to register to our English department or our department, you will get to a discount of 20% off, ya. Wow. Sampai yang paling tinggi bisa dapat setengah 50% nih potongannya ya, and you also get trophy and pop up. And these are our contact person. This is Jessica, it's me myself, and then Vivian, our committee. You can contact us to ask more about or furthermore about the competition and also the coaching, yeah. But once again, I'd like to tell you is that if you want to join the coaching sessions only, that will be fine, yeah. You can just register for free, yeah. The coaching sessions are for free, but for the competition, you need to join. You need to pay for like 50,000 only. That will be very cheap, yeah. Okay, now. If you still have questions, hold it for a while. I'm going to show you greetings, yeah, from two of our speakers, yeah. One of our speakers, Pak Andreas Wicaksono, like to tell you something. Oh, I hope I have already shared my sound. Sorry. Okay.
Halo semuanya, kita sama-sama akan belajar tentang bagaimana membuat vlog. Materinya antara lain, komposisi gambar,
dan tentunya editing video.
So, kesempatan ini adalah kesempatan emas buat kalian semua. Yuk, ikut yuk.
Okay, that is from Pak Andreas. Now we are go to our second video, which is from Pak Andreas. Yeah, this is an example of the vlog. Yeah, that kita akan dibawa jalan-jalan. Kalau kalian sekarang belum bisa jalan-jalan kemana-mana, ya, kita akan jalan-jalan ke Malang selain ini. Yeah. Alright, let's start the video. Okay, sorry. Wait for a while. Yeah. Alright, here he goes.
Suaru, Anjang Sana on the 1st of January. Hello everyone, it is me Andreas. On this occasion, I would like to tell you a bit about...
Yes? Someone wants to ask something? Anyone wants to ask something? Okay. Yeah, we'll see the video first, yeah? Okay. Wait for a while. I'm going to play the video once more. Yeah, okay. Sambil menunggu, mungkin bisa dilihat lagi rules and regulations-nya that has been played. Oh, sorry. That has been uploaded, I mean, in the Zoom chat. Yeah. While waiting for the video to be played. Okay, here you go.
Suaru, Anjang Sana on the 1st of January. Hello everyone, it is me Andreas. On this occasion, I would like to tell you a bit about a local wisdom in a village called Suaru. First of all, what do you have in mind when you hear about Malang City? Some of you might have a picture of tourist destinations like Jopan Rondo, Jangar, or the cool climate that the city has. Some of you may also imagine the apple fruit that the city is famous for. Others may also imagine the beautiful beaches like Sendang Biru, Balikambang, and other picturesque beaches situated in the city. Well, that is not wrong at all. But now, let me bring you to a part of Malang that not many people know about. This is about a small yet beautiful village called Suaru. The name is derived from two Japanese words, alas, which means forest, and waru, which refers to heart shape, which is also a name of a tree. Alas Waru, or Suaru for short, is located in the southern part of Malang, about 45-minute drive from the Malang city square. The suburban area is 2.6 square kilometers with as many as 1,994 people living in the village. 75% of its area is used for paddy fields, plantation areas for salak fruit, or people often call it snake fruit, and sugar cane. Now, I'm not making this video to tell you further about the village. Instead, I would like to tell you a unique thing that is considered to be a local tradition in this village. Unlike most places in Indonesia, of which citizens are Muslims, most of the residents in Suaru are Christians. It is even one of the largest Christian villages in Malang, apart from other villages like Peniwen, Sitiarjo, and Wonorejo. As we all know that when we talk about Christians, we always talk about Christmas or Easter as the religious days. However, like other Christians, people in Suaru celebrate Christmas on the 25th of December as there are Christmas masses on the 24th, and there is a Christmas celebration on the Christmas Eve. The celebration contains entertainments, as well as shows from the villagers themselves, and they even hire performers like professional wayang dancers to help with the event. Christmas celebration usually ends until midnight, and with huge fireworks event. In the next morning, on the Christmas Day, they come again to the church to hold the Mass. It is common for them to go to the church at least twice in a week to celebrate Christmas. Another interesting thing is that people will come from other areas in Malang, even from other cities, to the village to come to their friends and family's houses. This kind of activity is similar to the Japanese tradition of Anjang Sana, where people in Suaru pay a visit to one another, especially younger people to their older people or those for whom they respect for the service. Like my family and I, we would go to Pak Turiman's and Pak Harmeko's houses, as they were those who had become our witnesses of our marriage. Interestingly, if you go to the Suaru village on the 25th of December, the situation is very quiet as for this occasion. We do Anjang Sana on the 1st of January. This is different from our Muslim friends who do Anjang Sana on the day of Eid. There is no exact reason why people do so on the 1st of January instead of on the 25th. Yet, I think we just want to greet each other not only a Merry Christmas, but also a Happy New Year. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is an interesting local wisdom in my area when people visit one another not on the day of Christmas, but it's on the day of the New Year. So, even though we come to other people's houses on the 1st of January, it is still under the occasion of Christmas and New Year, of course. So this is a kind of local wisdom where we visit each other and ask for their health, for example, you know, just to make good relationships between one another. And this is an interesting local wisdom from my area. So ladies and gentlemen, if you want to go to Suaru village during the Christmas day to visit me, for example, don't come on the 25th of December, but you can come on the 1st of January instead. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video. I'm Andreas and this is my vlog. See you, bye.
All right, that was the video made by Andreas, one of our speakers, yeah. Now, please welcome Pak Andreas.
Yeah, thank you so much, Cici, for that. Hello, everyone. Udah siang
Hello.
Ya? Ini masih semangat ya? Ada yang puasa mungkin? Ya, ada ya. Ya, yes, selamat menjalankan ibadah puasa, okay? Right, so I only have a few minutes because I'm going to have a class. Jadi seharusnya saya jam 1 ngajar. Sedikit aja untuk SMA Untung Suropati. Saya kasih waktu sedikit aja, mohon maaf sekali. Jadi sebenarnya saya mau kasih Anda video tentang suatu, kenapa sih kita harus belajar bahasa Inggris? Kenapa kok kompetisinya dalam bahasa Inggris gitu? Intinya adalah supaya Anda bisa go international gitu ya. Mungkin banyak yang bisa selfie dengan bagus, bisa bikin TikTokan yang bagus. Nah, sekarang daripada kita TikTok, kita cari yang positif, produktif, gitu ya. Anda cari local wisdom, nilai-nilai positif di lingkungan Anda. Misalnya ada kayak saya tadi, Anjang Sana di desa Suaru, di desa istri saya. Kemudian biasanya kalau orang silaturahmi kan pada hari raya, gitu ya. Pada Idul Fitri atau Natal atau yang lainnya. Tapi di desa saya, desa kami. Kami silaturahmi pada tanggal 1 Januari begitu ya, karena untuk merayakan apa namanya Natal dan juga Tahun Baru. Jadi selamat Natal dan Tahun Baru sekalian gitu ya. Oke, saya ada punya beberapa pertanyaan di sini yang bisa kita jawab bersama-sama. Ada yang tahu jawaban nomor 1 nggak? There is only one word in the dictionary that spelled wrong. What is it? Ada yang tahu? Satu kata di kamus yang spellingnya itu salah. Ada yang tahu? Dari yang tahu ini. Tadi tiga pertanyaan ini dijawab oleh anak kelas 11 ya. Anak kelas 12 ini pasti lebih bisa dong. Ayo. Ada satu kata di kamus yang spellingnya itu salah. What is it? Ada yang tahu? Bisa diketik di chat mungkin? The answer is? Yeah. JJ, thank you so much. This the word is wrong itself. What about number 2? Ya, ada pertanyaan nomor 2. You are running a race and at the very end you pass the person in second place. What place did you finish the race in? Ada yang tahu enggak? Anda mau masuk garis finish, kemudian di depan Anda ini si nomor 2. Kemudian ada selip si nomor 2 ini. Anda jadi peringkat berapa? Anda menyalip peringkat 2, berarti Anda langsung masuk ke peringkat 2. Tentu saja, bukan peringkat 1 ya. Tapi kalau Anda menyalip peringkat 2, berarti Anda di posisi kedua, bukan posisi pertama. Good. What about the last question? How many months of the year have 28 days? Ada berapa bulan dalam satu tahun itu yang memiliki 28 hari? Ada yang tahu? February, tetot. Terima kasih sudah mencoba Isabella, tapi jawabannya adalah not only February, but also January, February, March, April, May, and so on until December. So, all months have 28 days, even more. Jadi semua bulan itu punya 28 hari, bahkan lebih. Saya punya satu jawaban, punya pertanyaan Pamungkas deh. What is a thing, ya, sebutkan satu benda, that we need to break it before we use it. Ya, satu benda yang kita harus pecahkan dulu sebelum kita memakainya. Jawabannya adalah, ada yang tahu? Isabella mungkin, atau yang lain? JJ tahu mungkin? Apa, J? Satu benda yang harus kita pecahkan dulu sebelum kita gunakan. Jawabannya adalah, yes, Fania Angel, that is correct, an egg. Love buat Anda, good job. Nah, ngapain sih Pak? Pak Andreas ngasih tanya jawab itu untuk melatih Anda critical thinking. Ya, kalau dalam bahasa Inggris itu tadi disebut English riddles, teka-teki untuk kita berpikir kritis. Nah, di coaching saya besok, kalau Anda mau join di kelas saya secara gratis, cukup luangkan waktu 2 jam saja. Critical thinking, Anda kita akan belajar critical thinking, kemudian kita akan menciptakan sebuah critical statement. Jadi critical thinking, pemikiran kritis akan menghasilkan critical statement. Kalimat-kalimat kritis atau dalam bahasa Indonesia lebih tepatnya kalimat-kalimat yang penting untuk didengar, ya, bukan kalimat-kalimat yang nonsens gitu ya. Kita akan juga belajar tujuannya apa untuk public speaking, vlogging itu untuk apa. Kita akan belajar tentang situasi retorika itu apa, situasi retorik itu apa. Kita juga akan belajar etika dalam vlogging, ya. Kita juga akan belajar step by step. Kita merencanakan, kita proofread skripnya, kita latihan stressing intonation-nya. Kemudian kita akan fokus ke speaking for vlogging, ya, public speaking for vlogging, terutama dalam konsepnya, structure, content, and putting into action. Dan kemudian akan saya tutup dengan tips-tips yang terbaik, begitu ya. Oke, sedikit glimpse, ya, sneak peek dari saya mengenai apa yang akan Anda pelajari di coaching session saya. Silakan ikut coaching session saya besok, kemudian Sabtu ikut punya Pak Andreas. Kemudian Anda ikut kompetisinya, bikin poster yang sekreatif mungkin, bikin vlog sekreatif mungkin, dan menangkan hadiah 3 juta rupiah. Wow, it's gonna be awesome, right? Saya mau undur diri ya, JJ, Pak Hadi, yes, terutama Bu Putri, saya harus mengajar jam 1. I'm not kind of a late person, so I'm trying to be on time. Thank you so much for the attention, thank you so much for the time, anak-anak SMA untuk Suropati. Kami tunggu ya, kami tunggu kehadirannya untuk join coaching session sama ikut lombanya. 3 juta rupiah dan potongan beasiswa dan lain sebagainya. Oke? Okay? Thank you so much. Sorry for the short time, really. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Thank you for the explanation and also the sneak peek. Yeah, it's literally sneak peek. Yeah. Okay. So that is the end of our agenda. We have introduced ourselves and also we have informed you about the competition as well and the coaching sessions. Yeah. I just sent you again about the registration links. Yeah. Anyone has questions? Any questions, please? Do you think it's all clear? Yes? Okay, perhaps Pak Hadi, you want to add something more?
Okay, so I think making vlog is something that you are close with, all right? So like you love camera, okay, you love video, you love picture, you have editing and stuff. So this is actually like a very, very much, you know, millennial competition. So why don't you just make time to join this one, you know, enjoy also the coaching session. And I'm sure if you're very serious about your project and you're very serious about submitting a video and also a poster to us, your school is going to be more than just willing to support you. Okay, so I guess Bu Putri is also here with us. which is also a sign that the school is supporting our activity. And of course, Google Tree is expecting that your school is going to send, you know, some representatives. Thank you so much, and please join the competition. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Bu Adi. Maybe yes. Bu Putri, you wanna add something?
Yeah. Miss, after this, can I ask you for this recording video?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, later, Bu Adi, yeah, can help to send the recording.
For the other class who hasn't joined this Zoom for today.
Okay.
I will encourage all of my students to join this competition and also the coaching.
Thank you for the support, Ms. Putri. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. All right. Anyone else has questions? Okay. I think if you don't have any questions, and maybe later on, if you have further, if you need further information, you can just contact us in the contact persons. Yeah. You can ask us more about the competition and also about the coaching sessions. Okay. I think that's the end of our session. Thank you very much once again for all of you, students of Untung Suropati, and also to the teacher, yeah, Ms. Putri, and we'll see you tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, so when I'm going to end the session, I'm going to send you the video. I will upload in Google Drive.
Okay, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your support. Okay, I'm going to end the video.